Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1423, COUNTIF, Multiple Conditions, and Excel 2003 or earlier. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Teresa. Teresa says, hey, look, I've been watching the podcast, trying to learn Excel all by myself, and I am up against a roadblock here. I figured out how to use COUNTIF to figure out how many of these records said Annie, and that's working great. But now I need to see how many of these records say Annie, and also where the class is B or A. Now, Teresa is in Excel 2003. They say they're upgrading to Excel 2010, but that's going to be a couple months from now, and we need the answer now. How do you explain to someone who's relatively new to Excel what the heck sum product does, right? This is absolutely insane. So I sent her this formula, and I promised that I would, on the podcast, try and explain in layman's terms what the heck is going on with sum product. Sum product is used when you have to use COUNTIF or SUMIF with multiple conditions in Excel 2003 or earlier. Sum product, we're going to have two arrays in this case. Each array is going to test for some conditions. So in parentheses, the first array is going to say, hey, go look through all of this stuff over here in column B, B2 to B14. I'm going to press the F4 key right here. I see that puts the dollar signs in, and see if that's equal to Annie. That's kind of like what the COUNTIF is doing. I'm going to press F4 one, two, three times here to freeze it just to column D. So that's the end of our first array. Next, times, in parentheses, go look through all of these classes over here in column A. Again, press F4, put dollar signs in, is equal to this letter A up here in F1, and we'll press F4 just twice to lock it down to the row. Close parentheses, and our formula is done. And it will actually give us the right answer. So if we go through here, we should have the total number is 13, which is the total number of records. It's working wonderfully, but what is it doing? What is this weird formula doing? We're gonna take a look back here in the formulas tab at evaluate formula, and that's gonna let us watch this formula get calculated in slow motion. All right, so the first thing it does is it looks through all of the names in B2 to B14 and sees if they're equal to, in this case, Claire. All right, so we'll evaluate that. And look at this, we get a whole bunch of false, false, true. So that must mean the third record is true. True, false. So I'm gonna guess just based on this, I'm gonna see two Claires right there, two Claires. Yep, so those corresponds to those trues, a bunch of falses, two more falses, then a true, all right, and so on. So that ends up with all these falses and trues. Now, I'm gonna press evaluate again. And we get the same thing. Next, it's going to go look through A2 to A14 and see if that's equal to G1. In this case, G1 is the letter B, so we'll evaluate. All right, now we get a bunch of trues and falses. Each time that there's a B there, I get a true. Each time that there's an A there, I get a false, and we'll evaluate again. All right, now this is where the magic actually happens. It's going to take these two arrays of falses and trues and multiply them together. That's the product portion of sum product. All right, and the way that it works is a false times true or false is false. The only way that you can end up with a true is if you have a true times a true. So we're going to look for a position where the first array has a true and the second array has a true. In other words, a row where Claire is in column B and whichever it is we're looking for, B, I think, is in column A. And so when I click evaluate, see, it all gets reduced down to either zeros or ones. A zero means either array had a false. A one means both arrays had a true in the same spot. So, looking at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, the fourth item, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the first record where we had Claire and B. And then there should be 1, 2 zeros and then a true. So, two more zeros and then a true and so on. And then finally, we're down here to a single array. That's where the sum takes over. It adds up all of those ones. Evaluate, and we get the answer of 3. All right, it works wonderfully. It's not as easy to understand as some ifs in Excel 2007 or Excel 2010. If you have either of those versions, definitely switch over to the some ifs. But if you're stuck back here in Excel 2003 or earlier, this cool function, really hard to understand, will solve your problem. Go ahead. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.